Hello friends, I'm Dr. Vinod Malkar, Professor of Marketing. In the last two videos, we have discussed about introduction to channel of distributions, then functions of channel of distributions. In this video, we are specifically going to take some of the examples of channel of distributions, where you come to know how exactly various companies are doing and strategies of channel of distributions. Taking an examples of first category, that is FMCG groups. So there are two top players in FMCG field like an Hindustan Unilever and Procter & Gamble. There are many Indian companies also. You can take an examples of Marico, Patanjali. These are companies where you find certain levels of channel of distributions. Hindustan Unilever is selling the products from the big bazaars or the big retailers. Then that is called as one level of channel of distributions. If you know you are living in the small village of India, then might be the products came to you with two levels of channel of distributions, like distributors, or wholesalers, and then retailers, and then consumers. So two levels or three levels of channel of distributions are also used by Hindustan Unilever. If the bulk products are sold through online retailers like Amazon and Flipkart, then we can call it as one level of channel of distributions. Taking another examples of automobile sectors. Generally, all automobiles are sold, like it may be a four-wheeler or two-wheelers, with one level of channel of distributions. We call it a dealer, but it is called as a retailers. So retailers who sells the products to an end users is called as a retailers. So all these two-wheelers and four-wheelers companies are using one level of channel of distributions. Taking another examples of another category like vegetables, fruits. If farmers are selling their goods to directly to the customer, we can say it's a zero level of channel of distributions. If they sell their products to market committee and the market committee goes to the retailers and then it goes to an end user, then it is called as a two level of channel of distributions. Sometimes in the vegetables and grain market, it is a big channel of distributions happens. Generally, farmers sold the grains to the mandis, where we can say that is one level of channel of distribution. Mandi sells to another distributors, then again two levels, then again it goes to retailers, and then it goes to end consumers. So number of channel of members will going to increase in case of agricultural commodity, which starts from 0 to 4 to 5 levels of channel of distributions. So it depends. Taking an examples of Patanjali, if you see that Patanjali has initially has started their own stores and own retailers networks. But later on, for convenience reasons, they had come up with both sides. They had given their products to sold to the Kirana shoppies and then their own retail outlets, somewhere they had established their counters, company outlets also. So zero level, one level, two level of channel of distributions nowadays again Patanjali's are used in the market. Taking some of the service examples. If you had started a small hotel, so you are producing the goods over there, you are having some price tag and selling the goods at that level. So it is, there is again zero level of channel of distributions, where you selling the goods to directly the end users. Taking an examples of the online retailers like Zomato, again in the hotel segments, where the customer put the orders, select the name of the hotels and order the foods. So again, in this case, there is one level of channel of distribution, consumer, Zomato, then the suppliers supplies their goods and then the items that you had ordered reach to the end users. With some other examples like a banks, if you want to open your savings accounts, you went to the banks, banks offers you the loan products, that is at the location, at the place, that is called as a channel of distribution of distributing the various banks products. Nowadays, one of the concepts of distribution has came arriving, that is franchising also. So company has designed their own model to distribute the products with the help of franchising. So try to understand the difference between the traditional retailing and franchising. The company has a full control on the distribution network in case of franchises. There is an agreement between franchisor, that is those who are offering the services, and the franchisee who runs that businesses. You take an example of Peter England, you take an example of McDonald, then you take an examples of various hotels like in Kamath Hotels. These are some of the examples that products are sold with the franchisees network. Nowadays, franchisees is one of the popular concepts, so that the manufacturers having a great control on their services. Like even in, you can take an in popular examples of Maharashtra like an Evle Tea, Evle Chaha. So they are also one of the famous franchising model nowadays in Maharashtra. Like an, you know, the Akash classes or Resonance classes, or many classes has come up also with some of the franchises concepts. So this is also the somewhat advanced level of channel of distributions the companies are using, and the advantages, and you have a great control, you have how to run the business, that you will going to train the channel members. So channel members are nothing but the partners of the business, the bloods of the business, where you can reach to the end users with them. So whether you can go with this way, franchises, or you go with the retailing, or we go with the traditional way or ways of appointing the various channel members. So this way also you can go ahead. So various companies are going with these kinds of examples. If you purchase the aeroplane tickets, you can purchase the aeroplane tickets from many online, like yatra.com, makemytrip.com, or you can directly purchase from the website of that aeroplanes services offering companies. So what I mean to say again, there are various kinds of services and goods through that the products are sold. And the every products has going with a different types of channels of distributions according to their products. The big companies, somewhat vacuum cleaner companies, are going with some of zero level of channel of distributions. So they are selling directly, the salesman comes to home and the products are sold to that end users. So it's totally depend on again a company and the type of customer and type of products which channel of distribution they should employ. So these are some of the few examples of channel of distributions. There is one important concepts in the channel of distributions nowadays, retailing. We should understand that one also. Organized retailing and unorganized retailing. In India, the retailing business are generally we can call as an unorganized retailing because of small retailers, number of small retailers in and around with us. Nowadays, some of the organized retailing like Big Bazaar, Pantaloon, some online retailers is also called as an organized retailing. They had started increasing their businesses in India. But in developed countries, you find mostly the business are organized retailing. There are different myths or different arguments on whether organized retailing good is or unorganized retailing is good. So there is a big network of unorganized retailing that some are certain having advantages and some of the disadvantages of these kinds of retailing. So at today's sessions, we had learned some of the examples of channel of distributions, then some of the what exactly the franchising means and what exactly the retailing means. I hope you had understood these three concepts of channel of distribution. Thank